come, let us go to the mountain of the Lord. Let us clap our hands in song. Come, you who thirst for serenity and truth, bring your heart and come along. Blessed are you who are spiritually poor, for the kingdom of heaven is yours. Happy are you who are mourning and bewailing, God will comfort his people. Come, let us go to the mountain of the Lord. Let us clap our hands in song. Come, you who thirst for serenity and truth, bring your heart and come along.
Blessed indeed are the humble-minded people, for they shall inherit the earth. Happy are you who are seeking after truth, for you will get satisfaction. Come, let us go to the mountain of the Lord. Let us clap our hands in song. Come, you who thirst for serenity and truth, bring your heart and come along. Happy are you who are merciful and kind, for the Lord shall be merciful too. Blessed are pure with no evil in their hearts, they will see their God in his glory. Come, let us go to the mountain of the Lord. Let us clap our hands in song. Come, you who thirst for serenity and truth, bring your heart and come along.
Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters. This holy mass is offered for the following intentions. Archdiocese of Hyderabad, Sanat Nagar Parish. This mass is offered for Poodota Ritika on her birthday from America, California, for good health, good future, for good grading in MED SAT examination writing in January 2021 by family members. Archdiocese of Visakhapatnam, Sitamadara Parish. This mass is offered for the departed soul of Ignatius Wicket by Elizabeth Francis and family, Das Wicket and family, Aloysius Wicket and family, Pushpa Wicket and family, Teresa and Ogayasi. Together with these intentions, let us also remember and pray for all the donors of Divyavani TV channel. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, both the readings today tells us how God intervenes in the life of people when we badly need him, or even when we don't even expect. How God intervenes and performs a miracle. And in today's readings, it is a miracle of making barren women bear children. And that is by the power of God. We hear in the gospel about the circumstances that surrounded the birth of John the Baptist. And that is what God is about, a God who cares for us, who does what we think is impossible for human capacity. And as we are approaching the solemnity and the birth of Jesus. This is the lesson that the Lord wants to teach us, that He is able to do what we think is impossible for us. So today, let us pray for the grace to rely on the Lord, to trust on the Lord, even when the situations appear hopeless for human capacity. And for the times we have failed to do so, for the times we have failed to put our trust in the Lord, let us make an examination of our conscience and ask for God's forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
You have come to heal the contrite, Lord, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who through the childbearing of the Holy Virgin graciously revealed the radiance of your glory to the world, grant, we pray, that we may venerate with integrity of faith the mystery of so wondrous an incarnation and always celebrate it with due reverence, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The birth of Samson was announced by an angel. First reading, a reading from the book of Judges, chapter 13, verse 2 to 7 and 24 to 25. And there was a certain man of Zora, of the tribe of the Danites, whose name was Mona, and his wife was barren and had no children. And the angel of the Lord appeared to the woman and said to her, "Behold, you are barren and have no children, but you shall conceive and bear a son. Therefore, beware and drink no wine, no strong drink, and eat nothing unclean. For lo, you shall conceive and bear a son. No razor shall come upon his head, for the boy shall be Nazirite to the God from birth, and he shall begin to deliver Israel from the hand of the Philistines." Then the woman came and told to her husband, "A man of God came to me, and his countenance was like the countenance of the angel of God. Very terrible. I did not ask him whence he was, and he did not tell me his name, but he said to me, "Behold, you shall conceive and bear a son. So then drink no wine, no strong drink, and eat nothing unclean. For the boy shall be a Nazarite to God from birth to the day of his death." And the woman bore a son and called his name Samson. And the boy grew, and the Lord blessed him, and the Spirit of the Lord began to stir him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For the psalm, your response shall be, "My lips are filled with your praise.
My lips are filled with your praise.
With your glory all the day long.
With your glory all the day long.
Be a rock where I can take refuge, a mighty stronghold to save me. For you are my rock, my stronghold. Free me from the hand of the wicked." Response: my lips are filled with your praise.
My lips are filled with your praise.
With your glory all the day long.
With your glory all the day long.
It is you, O Lord, who are my hope, my trust, O Lord, since my youth. On you I have learned from my birth, leaned from my birth. From my mother's womb, you have been my help. Response: my lips are filled with your praise.
My lips are filled with your praise.
With your glory all the day long.
With your glory all the day long.
I will declare the Lord's mighty deeds, proclaiming your justice, yours alone. O God, you have taught me from my youth, and I proclaim your wonders still. Response: my lips are filled with your praise.
My lips are filled with your praise.
With your glory all the day long.
With your glory all the day long.
Please stand for the gospel acclamation.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Root of Jesse, set up as a sign to your peoples, come to save us now, delay no more.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
The Lord be with you
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke, chapter 1, verses from 5 to 25. Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke, chapter the first, verses from 5 to 25. In the days of Herod, king of Judea, there was a priest named Zechariah of the division of Abijah, and he had a wife of the daughters of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. And they were both righteous before God, walking in all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord blameless. But they had no child, because Elizabeth was barren, and both were advanced in years. Now, while he was serving as priest before God, when his division was on duty, according to the custom of the priesthood, it fell to him by lot to enter the temple of the Lord and burn incense. And the whole multitude of the people were praying outside at the hour of incense. And there appeared to him an angel of the Lord standing on the right side of the altar of incense. And Zechariah was troubled because when he saw him, and fear fell upon him. But the angel said to him, "Do not be afraid, Zechariah, for your prayer is heard, and your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son, and you shall name him John. And you will have joy and gladness, and many will rejoice at his birth. For he will be great before the Lord, and he shall drink no wine nor strong drink, and he will be filled with the Holy Spirit, even from his mother's womb. And he will turn many of the sons of Israel to the Lord their God, and he will go before him in the spirit and power of Elijah, to turn the hearts of the fathers to the children, and the disobedient to the wisdom and the just, to make ready for the Lord a people prepared." And Zechariah said to the angel, "How shall I know this? For I am an old man, and my wife is advanced in years." And the angel answered him, "I am Gabriel, who stand in the presence of God. And I was sent to speak to you and to bring you this good news. And behold, you will be silent and unable to speak until the day that these things come to pass, because you did not believe my words, which will be fulfilled in their time." And the people were waiting for Zechariah, and they wondered at his delay in the temple. And when he came out, he could not speak to them, and they perceived that he had a vision in the temple. And he made signs to them and remained dumb. And when his time of service was ended, he went to his home. After these days, his wife Elizabeth conceived. And for 5 months she hid herself, saying, "Thus the Lord has done to me in the days when he looked on me to take away my reproach among men." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, the announcement to Zechariah about the birth of a son to his elderly wife, already she was past childbearing age and was clearly a birth which in normal circumstances should not have happened. Let us situate ourselves in the circumstances or in the culture of that time, where having children and especially having a boy was a wife's primary duty. And if you fail to produce a boy, if you fail to give birth to a boy or a child, that was a terrible shame. And that was considered a great failure, not so much on the part of the man, but on the part of the wife. Because one had been chosen as wife only for this purpose those days. A wife was chosen precisely to bear a child, to give birth to children. And other reasons like getting married for the sake of love, affection, that had nothing to do with those days. So marriages happened and the wife was considered like somebody who was called to produce children. And it was of course presumed that it was the wife who was responsible and not the husband. The failure was entirely was put on the blame of the wife. And that's why in the Holy Scriptures, the widows were listed among the most pitiable people. Such a woman, sometimes who might still be quite young due to the loss their husbands in the war, accident or disease, are deemed as second-hand material, who were not eligible for a remarriage, and so they could never become mothers. And being the mother of a son is what a woman was meant to be. A woman who could not be a mother was considered less than a person. So that was the condition, that was the situation at the time of the scriptures. And we could imagine Elizabeth in that condition, in that situation. But what God did? God intervenes. God intervenes in the lives of the people when they themselves least expected. And right through the scriptures, not only this incident, both in the Old Testament and the New Testament, the births of the significant people happen in circumstances, and those circumstances mainly happen because of God's or divine intervention. And in the Bible, there are so many elderly women who had never borne a child, but because God has intervened, they were blessed with a child. And we find mostly they gave birth to a boy and not to a girl. Because giving birth to a boy is a double blessing, unfortunately. So here also, Elizabeth's barrenness is seen less as a curse, but more as a preparation for something great. What is something great? Preparation for the birth of Jesus. And today's first reading, if you have paid attention by chance, it recounts one of the greatest of the births, of the birth of Samson. And what is peculiar to this birth story is that the boy to be born has a very significant role given by God. And also in the gospel, the significant role that God has given to Saint John the Baptist to prepare the way of the Lord. God made him so strong that people thought he was the savior. And because John the Baptist was so humble, he could not accept the false credit. If we were in the place of John the Baptist, we could claim, yes, I am the Jesus, worship me. Because you see, today on television, so many pastors, so many preachers claiming themselves, attributing themselves as gods. But John the Baptist, he was so humble. And that's why Jesus himself, you know, praised John the Baptist with these beautiful words. He said, you know, among the people who are born to a woman, nobody is greater than John the Baptist. That was the praise that Jesus had for John the Baptist. So now coming to the birth of John the Baptist, when the angel came to Zechariah and told that Elizabeth will conceive and bear a child, he finds it is very hard to believe. Who will believe? Because both are old. Physically, they are not in a position. They don't have the capacity physically. And secondly, you know, if he believes, because he is in the temple, inside the temple, and people are waiting outside for Zechariah. So when the angel came and told him that his wife would conceive a child, if Zechariah believes it, let us say, if he trusts it, and if he goes out and tells people, oh, I am going to be a father at this age, they will think, you know, this fellow's mind has gone crazy. What nonsense he's talking. People maybe could have thought, if he had proclaimed, if he had trusted what the angel said, people could have accused and called him insane to be able to say that. But you know, God protected him. You know how God protected him? He made him dumb so that he does not need to announce people. Because if he announces to people, maybe they will think he has gone mad at this age. But God protected him also by making him dumb. You keep quiet, okay? You don't need to talk anything. You don't need to tell people because I will do what has to be done. You just go and sit. And that's what Zechariah did. He went and he was, because he was made speechless, there is no interviews. You know, if something of that happens today, you see all the television journalists coming with their TV channels for interviewing. But God protected Zechariah not to give any interviews to anybody. He made him dumb. And God did what has to be done. And that's why the name John indicates God is gracious. God is gracious in more than one sense. He not only made Elizabeth, once who was now conceive a child, but God also was gracious to Zechariah and protected. Because God, instead of saying to people in words, God showed to people his power. But Zechariah, he has failed to trust the Lord. That's why he said, how is it possible? How can this happen? How can this take place? Because Zechariah was a priest and he knew the Old Testament. He knew about the first reading today. He knew how God has opened the wombs of so many elderly old women and how God has fulfilled his promises. But Zechariah has failed to trust. So, because of his failure to trust, God made him dumb. But being a dumb at that time was a blessing in disguise to protect himself from being called insane. Therefore, what is this story telling us? First of all, we need to believe that God fulfills his promises. His promises, many times, they look unbelievable. They look too true to trust. But then God neither deceives us or nor can be deceived by us. Once he makes a promise and he will see to it that it is fulfilled. Therefore, we need to be true and faithful to God. Today, looking at the example of Zechariah, let us learn to trust the Lord even when it is hard to trust. Amen. Let us all stand and make known to God our prayers and petitions. God, our loving Father, we pray for the Holy Catholic Church, for the Pope, the bishops, the priests, the nuns, and all the baptized laity, that we may continue to trust in you, no matter how hard it is for us to believe. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for the families that are offering this Mass, that their hearts' desires may be fulfilled. People who are celebrating their birthdays today, Lord, we ask you to bless them with bright future and good faith, utter trust in you. And people who are celebrating their wedding anniversaries today, they may model and mold their family life according to the Holy Family, that they may enjoy peace, forgiveness, and faith in their family life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, as we are fast approaching to celebrate the birth of your Son, help us to prepare our hearts so that we may not be content with external preparations, but we may repair our soul, decorate our soul to receive the baby Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a few moments, let's pray for our personal intentions. We make these prayers and the prayers in our hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May be acceptable to God, a loving Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look with favor, O Lord, we pray, on the offerings we lay upon your altars, that what we bring despite our weakness may be sanctified by your power through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of the Nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thumma Bala, our Archbishop, Bishop Pola, the Archbishop-elect, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed apostles, with Saint Joseph and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of God's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Amen. Prayer of Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come into my heart spiritually. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself to you wholly. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Lord Jesus, come, Lord Jesus, come. Come and be born in our hearts. Come dwell in us, Emmanuel. Come and be born in our hearts. Your people are waiting. Your people are waiting. Your people are waiting for you, Lord. Lord Jesus, come. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Come and be born in our hearts. Come live, Emmanuel, come and be born in our hearts.
Let us pray. As we give thanks, Almighty God, for these gifts you have bestowed, graciously arouse in us, we pray, the desire for those yet to come, that we may welcome the nativity of our Savior and honor it with minds made pure through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our holy mass is ended. Let us go in peace and joy of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Virgin, by God's decree, you were called eternally, that he could give his son to our race. Mary, we praise you, hail full of grace. Yeah.